One.
Hi, we're back again, and today we're going to talk about the law of reflection. Now, the law of reflection states that the angle of incidence is exactly equal to the angle of reflection. So if you have a mirror laying down and you shine a beam of light in, the angle of incident will be the exact angle that it is reflected from. Please look at the diagram over here of Mr. Markley shining a laser pointer on a mirror. And he strikes the mirror with the beam of light and it reflects up on the box at the very exact angle. Watch his hand as he changes the direction of his angle of incident, his angle of reflection changes in the exact proportion. Now, this is all based on some principles of light and general waves. Now, our first vocabulary term here is going to be reflection. Reflection occurs when a wave strikes an object and bounces off. So if I step out of my mountain condo in the morning and yell at my beautiful mountain range and I hear the echo coming back, that is a reflection. If I'm standing there brushing my teeth and I'm making sure I've not left anything in my teeth, that is my reflection. My image is striking the mirror and coming back directly at me. Now, all types of waves can be reflected. All types of waves. Don't forget that. The other concept I want you to listen to is diffraction. Now, this is when an object is caused to bend around. So the wave strikes an object and the object itself or the medium it's hitting bends the wave around an object. So think about walking into the bathroom and seeing the shower door. The shower door has the pattern on it and the pattern causes the light to bend in different directions so you can't see a clear image through it. So this would be like looking through something like wax paper. This would be translucent. You can see my hand behind it, but you cannot see a good, clear image. Looking through the shears on a window. Wax paper is a great example of this. The little boxes in the windows on envelopes sometimes are transparent, so they're crystal clear, whereas others are milky, so you can't see what's inside the envelope. If you're milky in your image and you cannot see clearly through it, then that is transparent and it's a diffusion gradient.
I want to see the light, we're burning in the... I want to see the light, we're burning in the... I want to see the light, we're burning in the...
All right, guys, Miss Jones just talked about diffraction. Now I'm going to talk about transmission. Transmission is the ability for light to be seen through an object. Can it go through that object? So I'm gonna do a demonstration with you. First, can you see me through this textbook? No, you cannot see me through the textbook because light cannot travel through this textbook to see me. This is considered opaque. Opaque means you cannot see light through a object or matter. Now, I'm going to show you another one. Can you see a little bit of my face or maybe my hand through this plastic? Yes, you can. You can kind of see it. If you even shine a light of a laser beam, it can kind of go through there, but not completely. So this is going to be considered translucent. You can kind of see through it, but not all the way through matter. This is considered translucent. Now, this one is you are very familiar with. You can see right through this matter. Just like a window, just like the openings in a car window, you can see right through this. This is considered transparent. You can see directly through this. Those three of opaque, you cannot see through, translucent, you can kind of see through, and transparent, you can see directly through. All three of these are considered transmission. Now, I'm gonna talk about two other ones as well. The first one is refraction. Personally, I think this is one of the coolest ones we have because it's the bending of a wave caused by the change of speed as it moves through one medium to another. First, a medium is considered a solid, liquid, or gas. You have to have two mediums no matter what. It has to be a solid, liquid, or gas. So my demonstration for you will be this large water, and I have kind of like a dowel rod. And if you zoom in, when you get close to this, you will see it actually change. It looks like it bends matter. So you can go and zoom up close to this. If you see, it's changing speeds as it goes through air to a liquid. And as it goes all the way through, it will look like this is actually bending. It is not. I'm going straight down into this, and it's gonna appear like it's broken because I'm changing from air to a liquid. It is changing speeds as the light hits these objects. The objects including the dowel rod, the air, and also the water, which is liquid. So I'll do that again. And you can do this at your home a lot. You could do this with water or a pencil. You could do this with a variety of objects. Refraction. This is where two objects will go and change. They will change speeds through two mediums of air, liquid, or gas, liquid, or a solid. The next one I'm going to demonstrate is absorption. This is how we see color. It is when atoms in a matter absorb the light, and the light energy is converted from one form to the other. So the example that we have on here is an apple. We know those bright red delicious apples that we love to eat. Light hits this. Remember, light is Roy G. Biv. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. It is the entire spectrum of color that is visible light. When visible light directly hits an object, the object will absorb it in the atoms of that matter and reflect the color that it is. So we see red because it absorbs all light and it reflects into our eye so we can see it. Hence why if you're in a dark room, you can't see anything. You don't know what colors are around you because it's the absence of light. Black is the absence of light, so therefore it's the absence of color. So when we look at this, we have to realize when we see color, we're absorbing it, the object's absorbing it, and it's going to be reflecting. When you see this chalkboard, light is hitting this chalkboard, it's absorbing all colors. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet, and reflecting green to your eyes. And that is how we see colors, through absorption. When you look at all of these, this is how waves actually behave. Whether it's sound waves, light waves, there's a variety of waves that act like this. We have reflection, diffraction, or also transmission, like opaque and translucent, transparent. We have refraction, which has to be two mediums. And absorption, this is how we see color. This is how light is absorbed. All of these are ways that waves actually behave in real life. There are many different examples that you'll see through your NTI packet that you will discover, and you'll actually do a few labs that you will see refraction, absorption, and reflection. Thank you.
Boy, I ain't talking about you. I'm talking to my own reflection. I'm talking to my own reflection. I'm talking to my own reflection. Boy, I ain't talking about you. I'm talking to my own reflection. I'm talking to my own reflection. I'm talking to my own reflection. Boy, I ain't talking about you. I'm talking to my own reflection. I'm talking to my own reflection. I'm talking to my own reflection. Boy, I ain't talking about you. I'm talking to my own reflection. I'm talking to my own reflection. I'm talking to my own reflection.
Guys, we hate to say goodbye. We miss you terribly. We can't wait till you're back at home where we belong. If you have any questions, please call.
You can email us. And also for our 7th grade maroon, you can totally comment on Google Classroom. I'll be there to answer any questions that you have.
By this point, most of you have my cell phone number. You can text me. Just let us know if you need anything, if there's anything we can do to make this quarantine a little bit more fun.
And I know also in your NTI packets, you'll see a playlist of YouTube videos that you can watch. I know this is our video. If you want to look at more videos, they're more than welcome to you.
In the days to come, if we're out for longer, please look forward to more information coming and maybe even some extra credit or some projects on the way.
Raven. Done!